guys, I'm Tori Sterling and welcome back to my channel. So a few videos ago I talked about how I just got back from a trip from Idaho and how I have really bad flying anxiety, but how I kind of have overcome it. I've learned to combat it and my flying has gotten way better. And then I also asked you guys wanted to see like a video about how to overcome flying anxiety and stuff like that, and pretty much all the comments on that video were saying yes. Before I jump into it, I just want to say very quickly thank you to Best Fiends for sponsoring this video. If you guys are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe. I upload new videos all the time, probably like 4 times a week, maybe even more if I'm feeling like it. So yeah, make sure you guys subscribe, and without any further ado, let's get on to this video. So my flying anxiety started because I had one really bad flight. I was coming home from Ohio to Philly, and it was like there was a blizzard like right about to hit Philly, and we were like one of the last few planes to be able to land that day. And pretty much my plane just got caught in a wind shear, and we were about to touch down, and as soon as we were about to touch down, we had to fly all the way back up. And it really freaked me out. And the pilot came on and said, you know, sorry, we got caught in a wind shear. I didn't know what it meant, so I then looked it up. And a wind shear, long story short, is the number one thing that takes planes down. So after that, I got really scared, and the whole experience of that flight really just threw me off. And since then, I've been very uneasy about flying. So that's kind of how mine started, but I mean, I couldn't stop traveling because I'm lucky enough to be able to travel a lot for YouTube, and also I went to school in Alabama, so I would fly back and forth pretty much all the time. So I had no other choice than to keep on flying, so I knew that I had to learn to overcome this. So my biggest tip is to distract yourself, and this can be with whatever you want. You can read, listen to music, watch a movie, talk to someone. I always like to watch a movie and play a game on my phone. So I've been playing the game Best Fiends lately. I'll show you what it looks like. So this is Best Fiends, currently on level 35. So basically it's a free puzzle game where you collect and build a team of fiends to defeat slugs that are correspondent of the same color. You can also connect the game to Facebook to compete with all your friends throughout the new leaderboards. If you guys play this game too, let me know in the comments down below what level you guys are on, because it honestly took me a little bit to get to my level. So I better be ahead of all you. And also with this month, you guys can play the Easter egg challenge, which is really cool. And if you beat all 16 challenges, you'll win the all new bunny character, which is super exciting. And the game is free to download, but if you download it using my link, which is in the description box, you will get $4.99 worth of gold and diamonds for free, which, believe me, it's a really big deal, and I'm taking advantage of that myself. If you guys want, I will leave the link in the description box down below if you guys to go download the game. But I think it's really important to distract yourself and not really think about what's going on and thinking about, you know, that you're 37,000 feet up in the air. So being able to play a game or watch a movie or reading a book, listening to music, whatever you have to do to distract yourself, it's really important. So my next tip is to really educate yourself about flying and how planes work, because honestly, knowledge is power. My grandma's sister, so it's that like my aunt, my great aunt, something like that, she said that she was really scared of planes, and she had to go to Russia. I think this might not even have been my grandma's sister, and she was really scared to fly. So what she did was she took a course all about airplanes, how they work, how they fly, how they can pretty much fly themselves, like stuff like that. And she said since then she's never been scared of flying. I truly believe that knowledge is power. I always like to kind of look up facts about planes and how they fly and what happens if an engine breaks and everything that could go wrong. I like to know what they can kind of do to fix any problems, or also just to calm my nerves and pretty much educate myself that the plane could fly itself. Like, the plane is made to stay up in the air. You just have to remember that. Something that is scary when you're up in the air is turbulence. And for me, how I kind of cope with turbulence is I just think that when I'm sailing, not like I sail all the time, but like when I'm out on a boat or something, every time I see dark water, that means that there's more wind on it and it's gonna be a little bit bumpier. So whenever I'm in the air and I feel like we're, you know, going through turbulence and it's a little bumpy, I think back to when I'm sailing, and it's just the current of the ocean. It's the current of the air. It's not taking the plane down. Turbulence won't take a plane down. Turbulence won't take a plane down. It's just how the air rolls. It's just the current. You know, there's movement up in the sky and up in the air, so it's not something to worry about. It just is choppy air, and planes are built to get through that. I've also heard that you have to think that you're in a submarine when you're up in the air during turbulence, and you just have to think that it's the current of the ocean. So whatever helps you cope with it. Also, when you're driving to the airport, I want you to be conscious of all the bumps that you guys hit along the way. And you don't think you're gonna crash every time you hit a bump. So you shouldn't think that the plane's gonna fall out of the sky every time you hit a bump in the air as well. Something that really helps my mom a lot, and she taught me this trick and it's helped me a lot too, is when you get to the airport, just look out the window and look at all the planes that are taking off and landing. Every single one of those planes are going to be just fine, and I know that your plane is too. Watch them all take off and land. It could calm down your nerves and just make you think that, okay, this is a routine thing. My flight isn't a special flight. This is just something like these pilots are coming to work today. The flight attendants are just coming to work today. It's just a normal work day for them. It's something to be worked up about because it's just an everyday life for everyone else. Even though this is not my normal part of my daily routine, this is part of their daily routine. They're not expecting anything to go bad, and neither should you. Something recently that has also really helped me a lot is watching flight attendant vlogs on YouTube. There's a lot of them, and pretty much it's just like moms and families and, you know, dads, and they just seriously, they're like, yeah, I have a flight to Phoenix and back today, and then that's it, you know, whatever, I'm just gonna get ready for my shift or whatever. And to me, it totally changed my perspective on flying. It seems more like a business now and less like transportation. So they're just going to a day of work and we are just going to travel somewhere. They really help me and they just make me realize that, you know what, I just need to calm down, because if this was an unsafe thing to do, they would absolutely not be flying people, and they wouldn't have, you know, all these people come out and work for them every day, and moms wouldn't be leaving their kids for this if this was unsafe. So you just really have to think about it in a new perspective. Something else is to find the underlying fear within flying. So for me, I'm scared of dying. That is like my biggest fear ever. So whenever I fly, I feel like, you know, if the plane falls down out of the sky, if it crashes, whatever, I'm dying and I'm dead. So I'm really scared of dying from a plane crash, not the actual plane crash itself. So once you find the underlying fear of why you're scared of flying, it kind of also helps you. So this sounds so dumb, but when I'm in the air, I'm literally like, Tori, you're not going to die. You are going to live. This is a safe flight. You are traveling safely. You are going to land safely. You are not dying. My last tip is to realize that the only way of getting somewhere, if you really want to get there, let's say you're flying from like Mississippi to Greece. You are not going to be able to drive there and then take a boat there and then drive there some more. The only way to get there is to fly. So if you want to go somewhere, you can't let the transportation method hold you back from getting to your destination. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that's all my tips that I have for you guys. I really hope this helped you. Just know that flying anxiety is super, super common. A lot of people that I talk to deal with this, and a lot of people don't like flying. So it's not an odd fear, it's very common actually. Just know that you can overcome it, and flying is weird with anxiety because a lot of times people will say that their first flight when they're scared is way better than their last flight than when they're scared. It just keeps getting worse every time, and I get that, but there comes a point where you're just like, okay, I have to do it, and then you start to get better with it. So. Yeah, I really hope you guys all enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And also, please leave any of your flying advice in the comments down below for anyone else to read. And, you know, maybe you guys can help someone else out, because I don't have all the tips in the world, and I would also love to pick up new tips from you guys as well. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys want to see more of my videos, you are in luck. My last video is right here. And if you guys want to see the tutorial on this look, that is right here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you in my next one. Bye!